When this season picks up, we find out where, in fact, Kenny went after he left April at the gas station, which is Mexico.
He's changed everything. He's tried to wash away his whole life and start anew. And so I think this, it's a big, stark change.
We always think that Kenny kind of sees himself as like the star of his own movie. And we figured that he sees himself as like an outlaw. And where outlaws always run off to is Mexico.
Season 2, Eastbound and Down, is like Eastbound and Down on steroids. It's crazy.
Well, you know, Kenny wants to get a whole new identity down in Mexico. So Kenny is a cockfighter, and he has cornrows.
I think Jody came up with that idea, and we ran with it.
We figured, like, what is something bad that Kenny Powers could be into in Mexico? And cockfighting just kind of rose to the top.
We had a great group of guys down there who worked with the cocks. I like to call them the cock whisperers. And they would put these little harnesses on them with like fishing line, and they would kind of get them riled up, and then right as they would come to each other, they'd pull them apart. It's nuts.
We tried to incorporate what is unethical about that specific event, but also, you know, kind of try to show what people enjoy about it. But no cocks were harmed in the making of this film. Except maybe Kenny's.
With everything that's gone on in Kenny's life, he's still unapologetic. You know, he's a little bit of a southern gentleman and then a huge asshole.
A lot of the attention will be directed at me.
Kenny has always been a boob man, but this season, Kenny meets a girl by the name of Vita, played by Ana de la Reguera, and he faces the conflict, the internal struggle, as to if he'll fully convert to being an ass man.
He kind of finds himself at a moral crossroads. Starting to think that perhaps he was wrong. Perhaps he's been an ass man this whole time and he didn't know it.
She sings Bob Seger covers. She's very free and sexy and open and kind of a little bit crazy.
The fact that we all love Bob Seger and we get to cover his songs in Spanish is pretty awesome.
Jody just called me up and he's like, dude, you gotta do the season of Eastbound Down. I was like, yeah, I'd love to.
And these characters are heightened to a degree, but they're also recognizable. And it is shocking and it is offensive to some. For me, it's always a great sign to have something that divides audiences, gets people talking. It's just part of developing a creative process that feels satisfying to us.
You just always go for a joke, and if it makes people laugh and if it continues to make people laugh, it usually stays in the script. Beyond that, it's just throw in as many dirty words and make it creative and just whatever makes us laugh, honestly.
Anything racist usually is from Jody. Anything really dirty is usually from Sean. I come with the heart and the funniest jokes. That's usually what I contribute, yeah.
I think the fans should expect the unexpected. We have a lot of secrets and we're gonna have a lot of fun along the way, so you'll have to watch and check it out.
He's as obnoxious and hysterical as ever. He still curses.
We've got some visitors that are here to play with us, so I think everybody will see where we're coming from and be pretty excited about it.
Along with a lot of great laughs and some more inappropriate comedy, you're also gonna have a lot of sadness, a lot of sincerity, and hopefully some redemption.
Kenny's quest goes deeper and further. He gets deep inside Mexico, and it is not pretty. No, not at all. Why is it?